music. Today I want to talk about this record right here. This is Floating Point's Crush, released on Ninja Tune in 2019. This was a record once it got announced that I was really looking forward to checking out. I was already a big fan of Floating Point's through some of his previous releases, including this 2014 house record that he put out, as well as his 2015 debut album, neither of which I'm going to try to pronounce because I know I'm going to screw him up. I'm terrible at pronouncing these kinds of names. But anyways, like I said, once he had started posting preview tracks for this record before its release, I got really excited because I liked the direction that Floating Points was taking his music. So I got really interested in checking this one out. And now that I've given this record quite a few listens, I wanted to share my thoughts and opinions of this record with you and let you know whether or not I think it's worth checking out. So with that little introduction out of the way, yeah, let's talk about this guy. For those of you who might not know who Floating Points is a one-man project from a man from the UK named Sam Shepherd, who's a bit of a jack of all trades, and surprisingly, he seems like he's kind of a master of all of them. Not only is he a multi-instrumentalist slash music producer, he's also a DJ, record collector, seemingly a synth enthusiast, as well as being a neuroscientist. Pretty incredible that he can do all of these things, and it seems like he can do them with a high degree of proficiency and skill. So like I said, I got into Floating Points' music through this record right here. And if you want to hear my full thoughts and opinions of this track, you can check out a very early blog post that I did where I ramble at great length as to why this was one of my favorite tracks that I'd heard that year. And then shortly after this, I ended up picking up his debut album, which at some point I would like to do a full review on because I'm kind of surprised at the lack of reviews for this album. And I definitely think this would end up on a best of the decade list for me, something I might be doing in the future. So look forward to that. And speaking of a lack of reviews, I'm kind of surprised that no one's tackled this one yet. The only review that I've really seen for it came from The Needle Drop, but that was in the form of a Why You Know review. I'm kind of surprised considering, at least in my world, I was under the impression Floating Points was a fairly prestigious artist and that people really respected his music and people were looking forward to his music. So it kind of surprises me that I haven't really seen more stuff on YouTube for this record. Although now saying that, I'm probably going to do a search on YouTube and find a whole shitload of reviews for this record, making me completely eat my words. One thing you can really say about Floating Points' music is it seems like you could really split it right down the middle. There's his more live band sounding stuff, which is definitely more of the sound on this record, and then more of his electronic music and occasionally more dance floor friendly stuff, which a lot of material like that shows up on this record. And funnily enough, you can sort of split this record into two halves as well. Half of it seems like it's devoted to ambient synth soundscapes that are augmented with some orchestral elements like horns and strings. And then the other parts of it feel like it's a mix of some of his favorite club sounds, whether it's house, techno, two-step garage, and even little elements of drum and bass end up showing up on this record. But when I first started listening to it, one thing that really stood out to me immediately and sort of boiling the sound down of this album is it really felt like Floating Points was making a modern day old school IDM record. There were a lot of elements that felt really familiar, but still had a bit of Floating Points' own sort of spin on things. So you can expect to hear a lot of really glitchy sounds, a lot of beat up drums, some really harsh elements mixing in with some very beautiful elements, like some really enveloping synth soundscapes combined with some really crushing, powerful drums. For the most part, I feel like I got exactly what I expected from this record. But surprisingly, I really like the more ambient sections of this record. The opener, which I think is a great scene setter, really comes in with these beautiful, beautiful strings and synths that make very evocative and very emotionally affecting track. It doesn't feel like it's placid, wallpapery ambient music. There's a certain flow and certain feeling to it that I really, really do like. And that pops pops up again. I'm gonna have to look at this. Requiem for CS70 and Strings, which is another early album ambient highlight. I just, again, does sort of the same thing as the opener with the way that the strings and the synths sort of combine together to make this just beautiful swirl of music. And it really feels more like a modern classical piece rather than a straight ambient track. There's this sort of float and flutter to it that's really sort of hard to put into words, but it never feels static. It never feels like it just creating a mood. It really does feel like a piece of music. And then splitting off from there, you have, like I said, some of the more IDM, the more electronic music tracks. And I feel like these tracks are pretty solid as well. Some of the highlights for me include the first track, Last Bloom, which leads into Anisic Modular, which I absolutely love. It has this approaching menace feel to it. And I really like the synth swells. I also really appreciate him pointing to less overt IDM and more pointing towards straightforward club music. And what's really cool about a lot of these tracks too, they don't just feel like headphone music. They actually do feel like you could play them in a club for a discerning listening audience, and I think people would honestly be into them. Other highlights include Les Alpex, which has this very tunnel-y techno vibe to it and is probably like one of the hardest hitting tracks on here. Again, his arrangements with the way that the synths come in, rise, and create tension and release is really, really impressive. And it contains some of the angriest and most aggressive sounding synths on the entire record. And sometimes he seems to take on straight up IDM music. One example of this is the track Environments, which contains a lot of the beat crushed process drums that you would associate with an Autechre or an Aphex Twin or Square Pusher, and he does it really, really well while still injecting a little bit of his club knowledge into the track. There's still enough energy in the song that it definitely feels like I said, you could play it in a club and get people moving to it. So it really does feel like there's sort of two halves to this record. There's the really beautiful, moving, ambient, pseudo-classical pieces on here, and the more up-tempo sort of electronic music tracks. And I'd say in general, everything works. His arrangements are beautiful. There's this great use of tension, buildup, and release. There's some really just beautiful synth textures mixed in with hard-hitting drums and some really just great, interesting sounds throughout this entire record. Originally, I was a little bit harsh on this record, I feel like, because there's a couple of just odd drum sounds that sort of don't really agree with me. The snare on Last Bloom, for whatever reason, really just bothers me. And the last two tracks on this record sort of just peter out and really don't feel quite as strong or as put together as some of the other tracks on here. But honestly, I gotta say, I really love this record. And I feel like the more that I listen to, the more I discover that I like it. There's a lot of musical layers going on in here. There's a lot of great arrangements. There's some emotional heft to this record, so it's really engaging to listen to. But also at the same time, like I said, there's enough energy on this record as well that it'll get you moving, so it doesn't necessarily just become a reflective mood album to listen to. Honestly, I feel like this is one of the best records of the year. I don't think it's quite in the same category as his 2015 debut album, but I still feel like it's a solid record nonetheless. It's definitely become one of my favorite records of 2015. So yeah, if you haven't checked out Floating Points Crush yet, highly recommend that you do, and easily one of my favorite records of 2015. So that's going to be it for me today, guys. Thanks, as always, for watching. If you've listened to this record, let me know what you thought about it down in the comments. If you want to hear this record for yourself, please head over to my WordPress or Steemit blogs, because that's where I will be posting audio links to this record or any of the records that I talk about on this channel, as well as head over to my Mixcloud. That's where you can check out Raw Select Radio, basically the audio component of this YouTube channel. There you can hear me play records like this one or any record that I have in my collection that I don't get a chance to talk about on this channel. Links to everything, as always, down in the description. So that's going to be it for me today, guys. Thanks, as always, for watching, and I will catch you in the next video. So until then, peace out!